So the deal is, how can I delicately put this? Our show funder, yep. Te Mango Pāho, they've got some research that suggests that the presenting team, led by you, my Simon Dallow, that's what I said, been saying that for a long time.
Yeah, cool.
You're getting a little whiter. Some people suggest that you're coming off as a white guy who's a panel beater from Linfield.
Well, from Linfield?
Exactly. Can I ask you a personal question?
Yeah, shoot.
As an aside, are you a white girl right now? Is that... Just some of you, yeah. Just some of the things you're doing, your fancy sunglasses. Is this knitwear you're wearing? Is that...
It's cotton.
Sure, it's knitwear. I know what you get paid, mate. You're a little too white bread. You gotta kind of soul it up, soulify, do what you have to do, but you gotta do it now.
Well, what do I do? I mean, what suntan, the sunbed, or spray tan, or, I mean, jump in an oven, cook my...
I don't know. Research suggests maybe you should date a dark girl. Take her out, go to KFC, watch a basketball game, you know, things like that. Go dancing to hip-hop music. Get jiggy with it.
What's up with the stereotypical shit? We don't need that stuff in this show. Well, what do you want me to do? Boss? Huh?
Well...
What, go down the pub, beat up some white guys? Get my missus to cook me some eggs?
It's a start.
Huh?
I love eggs. What's wrong with that? I'll come round to your house. She can cook us some eggs, put them on toast, a bit of sauce, lovely. Yeah, there you go. I'll take that computer as well. It's got to go. Sorry about
that.
You've got great product placement. Welcome back to the show, everybody. This is ASC. If you want to be our friends, please go Facebook or Twitter. We want all the likes. We need the likes, let's be honest. Round of applause for our special guest, Tamati Coffey, everybody.
There
he is tonight.
Talk for yourself. Okay, very good.
Now, talk to me about what now, and you kicking off around 2004.
2004, yep. Got the call up. Had never done any sort of TV before in my life. Wow. Aside from my Sale of the Century gig.
Hey,
the debut.
But yeah, basically went along to an audition. Didn't think I was going to get it, but just tried anyway and got it. And wow, it was scary. Going from doing no TV before to doing what was essentially live national kids TV, because kids TV is a whole nother beast, you know? You've got kids that just say the randomest stuff and, you know, they'll kick you in the leg or they'll spit on you or whatever, you know, and you've just got to roll with it.
Yeah.
And actually, to be honest, I think that's what makes you such a resilient presenter, is being able to deal with kids. If you can deal with kids and animals, you can deal with anything. You can deal with Paul Henry.
Yeah. You've been on. Exactly. You were on what now, Kelly? Were you?
Yeah, I was on it quite a few times with Tamati, but kind of hated on you guys because you would never gunge me.
Yeah,
I always wanted to get gunged, but what now would never let me.
I remember it was my first year at the beach house.
Yeah.
I don't know why we didn't gunge you. Maybe we'd run out, because the bosses love gunging anybody and everybody.
We why don't you Helen throw some water on her now? Like, make it a gunge.
Is that allowed?
Maybe we should do like a front on the But she should be in a white t-shirt, and we should be at a bar somewhere.
Reminds
me of Coyote Ugly downtown.
Right, let's get back on track, guys. Let's get back on track.
Hey, Tamati, I had a quick question. Now, me and my girlfriends, we were having a discussion after the last couple of Aotearoa social clubs. You know, we know men. So, I was going, wondering if you could help me out here. At a rating of 5, who would be the hottest out of my two boys here?
Just the two?
Yeah, just the two.
Because he doesn't count?
Yeah. Writing me off?
Because you just know that there's going to be nothing.
Don't let me down here.
Look at me.
Don't let me down here, cousin.
Go, get the sexy
eyes. Come on, sell it. Sell it.
Sell it.
Sell it.
Sell it. Sell it. Sell it.
Look at
do
him.
The pose. Sexy. Oh, no. Just
Oh, wow. I don't...
You're doing a big bounce. Oh, I'll go out for the pick bounce. Can you do a pick bounce?
Is that a lot of bounce?
You're calling it Max City. That's Max City right there.
That's a whole lot of nothing, actually.
Fault.
Yeah, sorry, but hey, you've got other talents.
And here we know, New Zealand's got talent.
Talking about bouncing, you bounce from what now into breakfast. That must have been, you know, like you call up to the head office.
Yeah, and it actually was that. They called me up into the big office and they got me up from Christchurch and they said, oh, yeah, we just want to have a meet and greet. And I was like, is it a job interview? And they were like, no, a meet and greet. I was like, what do I wear to a meet and greet? And they said, oh, just, you know, whatever goes. So I wore like this nice suit jacket and a T-shirt and some jeans and I walked in there and they basically offered me the breakfast weatherman job.
What's a kids' TV presenter know about weather, though, you know?
Oh, sweet. Honestly, I knew nothing about weather. And I said that to them when we were having our meet and greet. I said, look, I don't know anything about the weather. I said, is that a problem for your weatherman? And they said, oh, no. You can learn it on the job.
Oh, that's great.
Nice to know they're well qualified.
Oh, political science, degree in political science over here. So he's a smart man. He knows what he's talking about.
Also, where are you with your politics, obviously? You know, you're kind of lifting left.
Oh.
Lifting left?
I guess...
veering left?
Swinging left.
Once upon a time, a friend actually asked me, he said, oh, who are you going to vote for in the election? And then he pulled back and he goes, oh, hang on, let me decipher this. You're appreciative of the arts, you're Māori, you're gay, you're a vegetarian, you're probably on the left side of the spectrum, aren't you? And he was completely right. And I don't think that you need to be a rocket scientist to kind of work that out.
Tamati, oh, I always put my hand up.
Off you go, Manny.
Yeah, why do you put your hand up?
Just to ask a question.
Oh, yeah.
But on New Zealand's Got Talent, the sponsors tour, do you get a free car?
No.
Oh, why not?
No.
Do they like not give you a car for like 12 months to kind of cruise around in?
No.
Like, the man on New
Zealand's Got Talent. Didn't they just recall like 21,000 of
them?
They
have just recalled, 7 million, I think, worldwide or something like that.
Tell you one
thing,
though.
Shout to the sponsors.
Possibly you couldn't hold your arm up again. We could check out that sweat patch you got going on. It's pretty sweet. Look
at that. That was
on the posing.
Oh, it is too.
Hello. Smells like a steak and onion cheese pie there.
Oh,
well done.
Fantastic. Oh, also...
Oh, here we go again.
Also, people think I look like Jason Kerosene?
Kerosene.
do you think I look like everyone says I look like Jason Kerosene?
Do you know what? Jason is actually a very skinny, tiny guy. No offense to you. But bro, you've just got a bit more meat on going there, that's all.
What's he saying?
I don't know.
It's all those pies, Tammy.
That's my guess, anyway. Hey, yeah, I'm going to move on. Are you a fan of movies?
We're talking
movies. In New Zealand, we have famous show bands such as the Howard Morrison Quartet, the Quintickies, and the Highmarks. In Australia, they have these guys, all girls.
What's his problem? It's because we're black, stupid.
No, it's because you're ugly.
Get out of my life, you horrible little gobshites!
Well, today I started loving
you. That wasn't terrible. Do you sing anything other than that country and western shite?
Sorry, what's going with country and western, mate?
Oh, it's just wrong.
Well, what do you think we should sing?
One, two, three!
Okay, wrong hands, girls. Wrong hands. Ooh,
I bet you if you want to perform for the brothers in Vietnam, you gotta give them soul.
You're gonna manage them, are ya?
And mold them, and... shape.
You've got it within you, you just need to let it out.
Oh, mercy! Oh, can I have some mercy now?
Any questions?
I heard it through the grapevine.
Can you make it sound blacker?
And I wonder.
And your name again?
We're the Sapphires.
We'll see you in Saigon.
If you can't shake your moneymaker for the brothers tonight, y'all on the first plane back to Austria tomorrow.
Australia.
I'm the manager.
It would take a special man to manage me.
Well, you're looking at him!
Soul music is about loss. And they haven't given up. So every note that passes through your lips should have the tone of a woman who's grasping and fighting and desperate to retrieve what's been taken from her.
These Marines, they need something. They need what you can provide, and they need it tonight.
One, two, three.
I will lay down my life before I let any harm befall those girls. Like my little girl, Lucy.
Sapphires, everyone. Looks like a really good movie. And you've seen it, Kaylee, haven't
you? I have. I actually got the privilege of seeing it with Jessica. And she wasn't too confident actually singing all the songs. Yeah. She's hated it. But
Jessica who?
Malboy.
Okay.
Yeah.
Right.
The lead singer in it. But no, awesome movie to see, and I'd recommend it. It's a family movie too.
Right, okay. Mm-hmm. Now, have you, you a big movie fan?
Yeah. I do like going to the movies. I've also seen Sapphires. I thought it was awesome too.
Excellent.
And Jessica Malboy, she's got the like power and volume in her voice, and it just reverbs when she goes into those big songs. So awesome. But yeah, I'm into movies. I don't have enough time to watch them.
That's what I was thinking, because you're getting up early in the morning, right?
Yeah.
Not a late one.
So you'll usually find me. What's that?
What time do you like get up in the morning? Because I'm up early too. I'm sure up around the same time.
My alarm clock goes off at 3:20.
Oh, hell.
Oh, wow. I'm 3:10.
3:10, are you? I'll text you, actually. Yeah. I'll text you next time I wake up at 3:20 and I'll just say, hey, bro.
I'll text you at 3:10 and say, get up.
It's real funny, actually. At that time of the morning, you get up and as you drive into work, there's people still stumbling home, you know, from the night before. And I always think, oh, one day I'm going to be like you. But for now, I'm going to work.
You're doing a great job, bro. Well done, actually, too.
You can stumble out of here if you want tonight.
Yeah. All right.
I'm pretty sure one of the boys will share this.
All right. We are talking more movies and interesting films in weeks to come. Right now, important television that will change your life but probably make you laugh. He's Kenny. He's our Asian. He did this.
Kia ora. Ka kini takuewa. Ka whawhai tonu matu. Ake. Ake. Ake.
I'm here today because this land belongs to us. The water belongs to us. The sun belongs to us. We're dead serious, so stop laughing. The water belongs to us because I'm thirsty right now. Hey, do you know what you're doing? You know what you're doing?
Walking.
No, about the water.
Drinking.
And if you use it, you have to pay $2.
Doesn't say anything on the water fountain.
It says Maori on in here, you know?
Money, money, money.
Do you know you have to pay $2 for the sun tax for our Maoris?
Yeah, no.
It's gone through yesterday.
I reckon we should charge the Maori for the sun because it's damaging.
The sun?
Damaging.
Looks all right to me. I'll lie here. We represent Maori people.
Are you kidding me?
Come on, $2.
Seriously, you shouldn't stare at the sun here, it'll kill you.
They give us
$2
because the sun is crap today.
Yeah. The sun is not crap. Look at that. It's really joyful. They give me $1 and I give you a discount. Are you still going to pay the $2?
The next Maori guy I see, I'm going to ask him for $2.
I'll charge you $4. This is our land, our sun, our water. Stop loving. We are serious. Deep serious. Yeah, kia ora.